Hey guys, I'm Aaron, and I'm here to tell you the number one way to get better at SketchUp. So yes, we will absolutely be talking about the number one thing to do to get better at SketchUp. That's going to happen. I want to cover some other ways to get better, but they're not the best way, but they are good ways to get better. I want to cover about four or five of these, and then I'm also going to tell you the number one way. So before we go any further, if you watch this channel for a while, or if you have a lot of experience with learning SketchUp yourself, I would love to hear your thoughts before. Don't spoil it by going to the end of the video. Right now, before we go any further, type into the comments what you guess is the number one way to get better at SketchUp. Go ahead and type that in right now. I'll wait. Okay, awesome. Now that you've done that, let's hop in and let's look at some of the ways that you can get better at SketchUp that maybe aren't the ultimate way, but still good things to consider. Let's hop in. All right, so the first thing we're gonna talk about is SketchUp Campus. So learn.sketchup.com is, especially if you're new to SketchUp, the best possible way to learn SketchUp. So I want to, you know, throw this out there for anybody, especially if you're within the first month or two of using SketchUp and you're looking for ways to do stuff, head over here. I know it's structured learning and some people are going, I don't want to take a class. I just want to start using it. That's cool. That's great. Get in and use it. That's awesome. But to start to learn the basics, to find out where the things are, what the things are, what are we calling them? There's no better way to learn that than right here in SketchUp Campus. So I'm gonna say learn.sketchup.com. SketchUp Campus is an amazing way to start learning SketchUp. So check that out, absolutely, especially if you haven't before now. All right, another thing to do, the great way to learn SketchUp is YouTube. We're here. I'm basically calling out the place that we're hanging out together right this second. Our YouTube channel, SketchUp on YouTube.com, is a great way to come in here. And I'm not trying to, you know, blow myself up. We have a team that works on this content. It is amazing learning content. We do videos every week. Any day that we don't have a video like this one, we have shorts. Every Friday, we do a couple hours of live modeling. It's a great way to get more out of SketchUp. And again, like I said, this isn't supposed to be self-serving. I'm not here to say subscribe to our channel, but we do put out a lot of information. It is a great way, again, if you're at that intermediate spot and you want to get a little bit better and get regular drips of SketchUp learning, it is a great way to do it. So I would recommend checking it out. If you don't already follow us, check out, go subscribe to our channel, and we'll get you information on a regular basis. Another great way to learn SketchUp better. Another one in that same vein, if you are a reader type, I want to just throw out, there are several books out there that are great ways to learn more about SketchUp. Some of these books tend to go more towards specific workflows. There's books out there that are specific to construction or landscaping or something like that. There's general purpose books that go from beginning to intermediate. Check out the books that are out there. It can be tough. SketchUp puts out a new version every single year. Right, every year, it's 2025, we're on version 2025. I don't want to spoil anything for anybody, but next year, 2026, we're going to have a new version. It's probably going to be called 2026, but we'll see. A lot of times, books take a while to get printed, written, all that stuff. So a lot of times you'll look at books and it'll be like a year or two old as the software they'll show in it. Most of these books, the content inside still works, is still fresh. You might not have in the book examples of how to use the most recent changes to the software. The version of the books that I showed probably don't have PBR materials because they were written before that was part of the software. So the newer stuff's not gonna be in there, but the fundamentals, the foundational modeling, that kind of stuff is all in there, and it's so worth checking out. So books are another great way to learn more about SketchUp. Another thing, and this is one that goes, I don't know why we don't talk about this more. This is one of my favorite places to learn about SketchUp is the forum, forums.sketchup.com. This is a forum that is full of SketchUp. Makes sense, right? So this is a user forum. So it is primarily manned by SketchUp users, not necessarily staff like myself, not necessarily Trimble employees, but users, you guys. People go up and volunteer their time to answer questions. If you have a question to ask, somebody might reach out to me and go, hey, how do I do this thing? And if it's something I've never done before, I'll have to say, I don't know. I have an idea, but I don't know. Asking on the forum, you might find somebody who's done the exact same thing you're trying to do and tell you exactly what they went through. It is great because it's not limited to asking me a question on a live stream on Friday. It is putting it out here for tens of thousands of people who come through our forum. So it's a great spot to learn, especially if you have specific questions. That's a rough one, you know, because in general, how does push-pull work is one thing, but I have a specific geometry, and when I push-pull, it stops at a specific spot, and here's my, that kind of thing. That's what the forum's made for. Check it out. Great way to learn. But now, so all those things, those four things, SketchUp Campus, YouTube, the SketchUp books that are out there, and SketchUp Community are all amazing ways to learn and get better at SketchUp. But there is one thing, one process that is going to get you better at SketchUp than anything else. You ready for it? This is it. This is the big one. And if you haven't already put your idea in, and now that I've eliminated four others, go ahead and put it in now. But let's do this. This is go spend time in SketchUp. So this right here is an example from earlier this week. This is a simple little 10-minute modeling exercise. It's a 3D printable business card holder, but this kind of modeling is the thing that's going to get you better at SketchUp. Not this specifically. I'm not saying if you go do this 10-minute modeling, you're going to be better. Well, possibly. I mean, better is an incremental process. Spending time in SketchUp modeling is the way to get better at SketchUp. So, you know, when you say it like that, it just sounds so dumb and obvious and like, wow, I watched a video for that long for that. But no, I really wanted to sneak in all those other things too. But it's amazing to watch people. We get people who come through our forum, for example, who just started SketchUp, 2 weeks they've been in it, and they're wanting to know why they can't do this or they can't do that or how come this is so hard for them and that sort of thing. Because they haven't spent the time. They haven't used the tool. They don't know how to do it. So if you want to get better at using something, you got to spend time using it. So those other things that we looked at, those are resources that you should absolutely lean on. Don't try to figure stuff out by yourself. Don't bang your head on the wall. Don't try to model something and suffer through the struggles you're having. Get help for sure, but do it while also using SketchUp. One of the things I have told so many users, especially if you're newer, is get a pet project. If you're using SketchUp for work, that's awesome. Do what you gotta do for work, but get a pet project. If you're just using it for fun, awesome. Get a pet project. Get something that doesn't have a deadline, that doesn't have to be exact, doesn't have to be perfect, that you could start over at any time. Something that is manageable. Don't start trying to model a detailed soccer stadium in your first week in SketchUp because it's gonna drive you crazy and get upset and you're gonna throw it all away. Model something simple. Model a single chair from the stadium. Model a soccer ball. That's actually kind of tricky with the geometry, but it is doable. Do those things. Do the little things that you can spend time on, spend your lunch hour, spend your evening on it, that kind of thing. But make it a project that you like, something that's fun for you, and that you can step away or not finish, and it's going to be okay. The worst way to try to learn software from scratch, especially, is to start from the beginning under the gun on production work that you have to get finished. It's a terrible pressure to put yourself under, and it makes it much easier to succeed. If you're an intermediate user and getting better and better, a lot of people think they get to the spot and they're like, well, I've done everything I could. I've already taken the SketchUp Campus courses. I've already subscribed to YouTube. I watch those videos every week. I'm done. That's great. That information's good. But if you don't practice, if you don't use it regularly, then it doesn't matter how many resources you refer to. You got to use them in order to have them help you grow. So that's it. Spoiler. We're at the end, so I can't really spoil it. But that's the one thing. The one thing you can do to get better using SketchUp is use SketchUp. If you like that video, click like down below. And if you haven't already, please do subscribe. We create several videos each and every week. be notified of all of them if you subscribe. Most importantly, though, leave us a comment. If you did leave a comment, did you guess right? Were you close? Did you get off? Do you have something totally out of, just something I didn't even touch on? Let me know down in the comments. And if you have another idea for a video, if this kind of information is good, where we're not necessarily in SketchUp, but advising how to learn, let me know about that. Or if there's some other specific thing you think we should model or talk about, let us know that too. We like making these videos a lot, but we like them even more when they're showing something you want to see. Thank you.